Let's discuss about the strength of electric field. As we already discussed that electric field is responsible for force on electric charges. Now, about the strength of electric field, we can write at a point in the region of electric field, its strength is defined as the magnitude of force experienced by a unit positive charge. As we already discussed that the direction of electric field is given by the direction on positive charge and its strength is defined by the magnitude of force experienced by a unit positive charge. Again, say we consider a region of electric field. Say this is a region of electric field in which we place a charge Q naught. Say plus Q naught, a charge we place at a point P, at the location P in this region. And if we release the charge, say it experiences a force in this direction, this F. In that situation, we can simply state at point P, the strength of electric field is given as, this is denoted by EP vector. E is the symbol used for strength of electric field. It is also sometimes called as intensity of electric field, like the case of gravitational field. Always remember, dear students, that intensity doesn't mean power or energy per unit area flowing. In this situation, intensity is just a term we are using to denote the strength of electric field. So, in this situation, this electric field strength can be given as F by Q naught. In this situation, this will be the magnitude of electric field. Its unit we can simply state as Newton per Coulomb. And for measurement of electric field like gravitational field, here the charge which we use is termed as test charge. And you can also keep in mind the basic definition of a test charge. It is a very small magnitude positive charge which it does not produce its own significant electric field. Ideally, a test charge does not produce any electric field in its surrounding. So, when a test charge is placed at a point, it will not alter the external electric field which we wish to measure. So, if on a test charge Q naught, the force experienced is F, the electric field strength at this location can be given as F by Q naught and its unit will be taken as Newton per Coulomb. In continuation, let's understand why a test charge is needed for measurement of electric field. For this, let's discuss the understanding of a test charge with the help of a realistic application. Here you can see, we are having a solid metal sphere on which a charge is uniformly distributed. And say at this point P, we wish to measure the electric field due to this sphere, certainly which exists in radially outward direction due to the positive charge. And say to measure this electric field, we place a generalized charge plus Q over here. Now see, if a charge is placed, what will happen? Now due to the induction effects of this charge, you can see the charge which was distributed on the metal sphere is redistributed due to inductions. And because of placement of this plus Q, electrons are shifted to the right and positive charge is shifted toward left. And due to this, you can see on the right side or the facing surface of this metal sphere, the charge density is reduced. And due to which we can see the electric field which we were willing to measure at the location of point P will be decreased. So, if we talk about the force experienced by this charge Q, say if it is F, then in this situation the measured electric field EM will be written as F by Q. And certainly the electric field which we were willing to measure was say EP, then we can simply state if we measure electric field by using this logic, then the value of this measured electric field would be less than EP, which we were willing to measure. This is because that the charge which we have used for measurement is such a charge which is producing some induction effects due to its own electric field onto the metal sphere, due to which the electric field which we were measuring is decreased. That's why a common charge cannot be used for measurement of electric field in this manner. Now let's see again what will happen if we use a test charge for measurement. Then we can simply state, as we already discussed, a test charge does not produce its own electric field. This implies we can say a test charge cannot produce any induction effects in its surrounding. So, in this situation, say we just remove this charge and we can see now the electric field is symmetric and radially outward due to this sphere. And if we place a test charge Q0 which is tending to 0, then in this situation we can see due to the placement of charge, the electric field configuration due to the sphere is not altered because this test charge is not producing any induction effect on the sphere. So, what electric field we are measuring by using a test charge, here we can write that the measured electric field is equals to F by Q0, where we can write Q0 is tending to 0. In this situation, this will be equal to EP, the electric field which we were willing to measure. This is the way how we can experimentally measure the electric field due to a body. And for this purpose, we need a test charge because external charges of finite magnitude may alter the electric field which is to be measured.